Atrial Fibrillation and Alcohol, the complete guide to understanding the connection, created by Upalife. From 2.7 to 6.1 million people in the US are living with atrial fibrillation, also called AF, which is a highly prevalent heart rhythm disorder. The problem is that not many patients fully understand the connection between AF and alcohol. They either drink too much or don't control their intake very often that ends up worsening their AF symptoms. Here, we will take a closer look at the correlation between alcohol consumption and AF. According to Harvard Health, alcohol is a well-known risk for AF. This condition forces the organ to beat faster and irregularly. Records show that those who binge drink too often have a higher chance of developing AF than someone who doesn't drink at all. Therefore, for patients who already have AF, paying attention to the alcohol intake becomes a necessity. Based on National Center for Biotechnology Information reports, alcohol consumption can drastically elevate blood pressure and result in weight gain. Both of these problems are associated with AF. Consuming a lot of alcohol, whether it is wine or beer, can trigger symptoms of the condition. The heartbeat will get quicker, patients might experience chest pain and pressure, and even faint. Since these drinks are packed with healthy antioxidants, many people fail to recognize the connection between beer and AF. But, the moment you start drinking too much, rhythm irregularities will become even more impactful. The same thing applies to AF and red wine. The antioxidants in wine are incredibly beneficial for the body. However, patients who recently had a heart operation have a higher chance of experiencing cardiovascular problems after drinking a little bit of this beverage. Consuming too much alcohol can trigger AF, but abruptly cutting back on drinking might have an even bigger impact, advises the American College of Cardiology. People who have a habit of drinking regularly will find it difficult to suddenly stop consuming. To quench their need, they might end up consuming more than they planned for. Therefore, it is best to consume alcohol in moderation. It's suggested that women shouldn't have more than 7 drinks a week, but men shouldn't have more than 14 drinks. This way, patients get to control their symptoms and avoid triggers. For ultimate results, it is best to slowly cut back on alcohol and eventually stop consuming it completely. Getting the right alcohol-induced AF treatment is crucial for managing the health problem. When the heart is beating out of sync, it throws the entire system out of balance. If you start to feel pain in the chest, you need to call an ambulance right away. The symptoms might be a sign of a heart attack. In less severe cases, there are other ways you can manage alcohol-induced AF. You can try mindful deep breathing to calm and soothe the nerves when the heart feels out of sync. Wash your face with cold water to stimulate the vagus nerve and force the body to respond to the quickened heart rate. You can also drink plenty of water because too much alcohol can dehydrate the system and cause dizziness. Once the episode passes successfully, contact your physician to update them on what you experienced. They will do some tests that can help you better control your health problem. If the condition appears more often, you might have to get a different treatment. If you are interested in including alcohol as part of your diet, you should watch the alcohol intake and have alcohol-free days. You should also regularly monitor your heart condition, include more minerals and healthy fluids in your diet, and get plenty of sleep. Conclusion. With the right balancing tactics, you can control AF symptoms and still drink alcohol from time to time. The key is moderation. However, if you can skip the drinking, it is best to drop it off your diet completely. Learn more about how to evaluate your heart health and manage your heart condition at home by visiting upalife.com.